Hi, John here, back again. Today is Friday, the 8th of April 2016. I've just wrote a letter to letterhead to the Navy, Jo Shannon. She's the assistant executive to the Chief of Navy, the Royal New Zealand Navy, Rear Admiral John Martin. He's away overseas at the moment. So I've put the agenda together for her to send a representative on behalf of the Navy to assist with the ceremony and the flag raising on the treaty grounds with the Admiralty ship of King William flag change from the crossbar with the British flag on one side and this 1834 Whakaputanga flag, that's the Declaration of Independence, to 1835. From the 10th of March 1834 at Russell, that's the first contract of the immigrants, and have come from Devon, England, and settled in Russell, Bay of Islands. So that's the first arrivals of the Navy settlers in that village on the Ngāti Rahiri, Ngāti Rehia, and Ngāti Kaua land blocks, the Te Tī, Marae, and also Te Tī blocks and the Waitangi blocks, lands that I'm administering at the moment with the original titles of the Ututonga, one house on the whole of the Bay of Islands title. I've got it here in these books, all the books I have on the bag you see at the back of me here. I took to Otau, Marae, in the Hokianga area, and also explain these at the Hui on the 13th, 14th, 15th of April 2016. It is the overriding title, Native, that is missing from all that history at Waitangi. I'm putting definition to legal documents here, these documents, straight to Westminster, England. Okay, we've got the Charter, the government of Aotearoa, okay, it's in that book. So all these are left with me from the chiefs, gone by, so I'm going to share it with everybody at this hui. It's very important that the taumata from the 39 marais in the region of Ngāpuhi, Ngū Tonu, to turn up at their hui, to hear the rest of the missing links to your whakamininga flag, the chiefs and the elders are responsible to put their flag up after 182 years this year. On the 10th of March 1834, this flag went up on the Kororareka on the hill, and the Navy puts it up every year religiously to link themselves to Britain, UK, Westminster, to that landlocked occupation, these titles on the lands, native lands for that matter, that I'm administering as the native assessor and also the customary legal advocate assignee to those land blocks. Now, I've just got a call today from Wairiti. She's in charge of the Te Tī Marae hire, and so she left me some details because I'm taking responsibility or the hire of the Marae's, no different from me hiring Marae's in the past in Auckland and down on the East Coast. Very rigid and specific, the same as up in Mahuka, and Ngāti Pro runs his hui, straight to the point. So I just want to express to the people there that are coming, let me know, because they wanted the numbers. We couldn't determine the numbers who are coming, because it took me a week and a half or to 2 weeks waiting for an answer from the Waitangi Marae Committee, Titi, and also the Treaty of Waitangi Committee grounds. So it took a bit of time for them to mull over all the details I had for this hui. It's historic. In fact, it's the most important hui of all times since this flag flew in the first place 182 years ago. That's the 1834 flag of a contract mortgage lien. It's a big difference to the other kotahitanga flags that are not contract mortgage bank liens. And in Westminster, where the Navy sticks this flag up for reasons legal, connecting the Crown in Britain to New Zealand through the Hapu chiefs. Okay? But no marriage then. In 1834, 1835 even, there was no marriage. There was only native, and that's the way we treat it, because the Moai statue was out in its history from 300 AD. 300 AD is the figure that the British put on history as being to their likings. So that's what we're going under, the two memorials in this whole title to these lands. The Moai is a Tahitian memorial in stone that's standing in the most powerful countries in the world, including London. Queen Victoria picked up the first of the Moais on East Island in 1868 and shipped it on the Topaz HM ship under the Navy British rule of the law of the sea, of Admiralty, and took it to England. That's the title I'm going under. With this flag, King William, Man's Law, L-A-W, and Moai Law, L-O-R-E, Spirit, God's True Face Law. My word against yours, put it that way. So those two memorials are what I'm talking about in all these books of title at Waitangi, at this hui. It's missing in all of the Crown Corporation's titles, the Lens titles and the New South Wales corporate government titles, government in exile. It's still running a three-year government while we get our governments sorted out. And so that's the charter there in the United Nations in that book. Okay, so I'm holding that as well from Mohi Manukau, and their confederation of chiefs is quite separate again to the eight tribes of Ngāpuhi, Nui Tonu, Whakamininga. Big difference in the two. The confederation of united tribes spread around the countryside. The 1834 was just the settlers from Britain that brought that title here. And those are the titles I'm doing with the Rogan Wānoa and Rogan Manukau titles. Manukau, Paihia titles, and Kaipara, Auckland titles to Waikato. And then the Rogan Wānoa titles, East Cape, in our Uataha district area, where Uataha Hapu originates with the Moai statue, the Wānoa landlocks and Wānoa people of Raiatea Island, Tahiti, and East Island. Okay, so that's that. Right here, in this, you see here, the Moai statue memorial. So that's God's law that I administer as inherited. And you'll see King William's memorial here in Devon, England, came from there. His court house of Admiralty, court martial law in the Rolls Building, Fetter Lane, London. That's our court for this flag, straight there. Okay, so that's the authority I'm going under. Marae and King William here in this book, title to this country. There, okay? So, now, we have the Marae at Te Tī for the 2 days and a little bit. And we have the Marae at Waitangi on the other side, the top Marae, as they call it. The treaty grounds. And the committee has let us use it to have a hui there. With the Navy, I'm appealing to you because John Martin, Rear Admiral, Chief of Navy, is away overseas. Then we expect a representative from the Navy to come to this hui, to the Porphyry, which is on the 13th of April 2016, on Te Tī Marae at 10 o'clock in the morning. We hope that you can reply to the letter that I've sent you a minute ago, Joe Shannon, Executive Assistant. Please let me know who is coming in history to record the Navy side of the 182 years this flag has been flying at Russell on Kororareka. On your behalf, whoever's representing the British Navy can talk on the Marae with the taumata and all the chiefs on the 39 hapū so far are coming. I've been to their huis and it's well and truly engrossed in their minds that this flag shall be raised with or without the Navy being dead. I've written the letter that they accept the Navy's silence if they do not want to come, but that we shall raise the flag ourselves on that ship. We are confiscating the lands and everything stuck to it because of the default of Queen Elizabeth II from Westminster to EU Parliament and left John Key with no queen, monarch, sovereign authority seal. He has not got the Queen's seal to open the Supreme Court of New Zealand. He has not got the statement of confidence from the British Parliament, Westminster, or the Queen, monarch, or King William IV's statement of confidence in the flag that's continuing in sovereignty unbroken for as many as 182 years when you first arrived, the British. Now, I'm not so sure if it's important for John Martin, after 3 letters I wrote to him, never replied to any of the 3 letters on behalf of the chiefs of the Whakaminina and this Whakaputana flag, Declaration of Independence, flag of the hapū given by the King of England. So the King of England still reigns in our law. In Westminster Parliament, it's fixed institute law extend. That means forevermore, until we change, that partnership remains with the British military and Westminster government. Just to let you know, that's what this flag is supposed to be on the top run, running this country. They are in a position now, we had our meetings and our resolutions on Te Tī Marae, the 3rd of February, was a TPPA meeting, unanimously passed that John Key did not come onto that marae because the people didn't want him there, as he signed the TPPA without their consent. That means he has no consent, because he can't come on the marae to get it. He can delay or elay all counts of John Key not coming onto the marae as all right. It's not all right, because he has to come to the lower marae before he goes to the top marae. In fact, the lower marae is the upper house of this country, and the lower house of parliament is in Wellington. John Key's government is a lower house. This is the main house of parliament on Te Tihi Marae. Okay, so just to let you know that everything we're doing stands its ground in front of the British military, our higher authority of the King of England, prevails over the absent Queen of England. She's now the Queen of Brussels in the EU Parliament, as a conflict of interest with John Key and his government has no authority to rule this country. I just warn the police to step aside while we do our business with this flag, as I was doing on Cook Street. That land shall be seized, the same way as the lands of the Waitangi Blocks land and Te Tihi Marae Blocks land. The Hapu chiefs have agreed that those lands will be seized back into the occupation title hold of Ngāti Rahi, Ngāti Rihira, Ngāti Kaua, Hapu, and their chiefs, elders, custody, everything stuck to the land, everything on Cook Street stuck to the land, shall set the precedent for any other land title confiscation with the sheriff's badge that I'm wearing on my shirt. Okay? And that's going straight to Devon, England, on King William's property, right here. And this photo here of King William Yard with his memorial right there in Devon, England. Okay, so that's our authority, high authority of jurisdiction over this country. Okay, so now, I just want to let you know that I spoke to, first of all, I'll finish off with the Navy. I'll address the Navy and Joe that we require you to send a representative to speak on the marae to the chiefs so that we can get your side of the story beside ours. There's something missing in what has happened with the Navy putting our flag up on Kororareka. I have some more information about $3 trillion the Navy has taken from the flag. I want to find out about that myself, doing investigations, because I'm a private investigator of our native titles by right of inheritance to these lands. I'm just one of them that is checking the running of this country and its administration with our administrators. We have our administrators, Navy, you are responsible to our protection while you're here from the laws of the sea that we have in this book, the laws of the sea and the laws of the land. Landlords of England is what we are expressing and enforcing. 1830, 1837, King William Acts of Westminster Parliament, we are administering that law. Okay? Straight there. Straight there. That's our business in private with the British military. They are coming here on our land blocks at Eastgate. So, to you, Joe, it is your duty to come to represent the Navy after this many years to give an account to the Taumata elders on the Marae on the 13th of April 2016 at 10 o'clock. The pōwhiri will be specially for you and all the Confederation of Chiefs who are coming specifically to honour this flag and honour the King of England and honour our tūpunas in that tūpuna whare at Te Tihi Marae. Okay? There's a fair measure of English people in there too. So, please come and do the honourable thing and change the flag. Take the 1902 flag from the top of the mast of the Ship of Admiralty and put it on the crossbar because it represents the war veterans. And John Key wanted to put his fern flag up there and forget about the war veterans. Where were they going to go? You see? They were going to just throw them out and put that up and forget about it. No. Put them over here opposite the British and raise this flag where into its rightful position of ruling authority of the King of England. Now that the Queen's gone, we've said that, and carry on the monarchy back to the Queen, King Ernest Augustus in England. Okay, we're filling the spot for him at the moment until we get this up and put it up in Devon, England, on this block of land. Okay, Navy? They are obligated, the British Navy is obligated to us to come here because you're not representing us and the police is not representing us and our natives in this land that you're occupying with lease land titles that can terminate any time as a consequence of breaking our law. Breaking our law. We're allowed to use our law and we are now. We are. So, as a consequence, the government forfeits everything of its business to the hapū and the people who are supporting this regime. It was less than half of the people voted for John Key and the new flag. That was a divide in the people who wanted to do away with our flag that got them on the land in the first place and the war veterans that fought for this country. They're tending to forget about that. Well, we can forget about them because this is a ruling authority over the whole world. This flag is an international flag, free trade, free passage through the world, anywhere we go. Okay? So that's what I'm saying. Please send somebody and sort it out. Now, with the Marae hire. The Marae, person in charge, Wairiki, she's gone over a few things with me, the rules, the protocols of the Marae, I'm quite used to that, and the costs. The cost to hire that Marae for the 2 days and a bit comes to $700 a day. That's for the use of the Marae to sleep, the wharekai, to bring our own food and catering. And it's only going to cater for 60 people. Any more than that, then we have to foot the bill. So that's why I'm appealing to all you people who are thinking of coming, let me know, because I don't want surprises. Otherwise we're going to end up on the road and do the hui there. And that's not very good for a big occasion like this. Because she said, the sounds of it, the looks of it, it's going to be more people. So I'm appealing to the taumata from the 39 hapū and Matua Pōhepa, Ebiha, and Willie Pater and all the rest of them to gather a little pennies together and let me know the cost. I need to know before next Wednesday. I need to know in advance whether we're going to have a hui or not. No marae, no hui. Simple as that. When we've got yeses. We've got yeses so far, bar the Navy. We've got access to the flagpole to put the flag up. We've got access into the marae on the treaty grounds. We've got access onto the Te Tihi marae. Now the cost of hiring the marae and the paddock. If we need the paddock, we still have to pay for that, but that's included in the cost by the sounds of it, of what she's saying, but that can change. If we don't need the camping ground in the paddock and the toilets there, then that will be reflected in the cost. So it's $1,400 for the 2 days, and the total cost for the hire with the bond of $500 is $2,874.75. That's for the period of time for the whole complex, because of the nature of the hui. It's very important that the message is fitted into history, and if necessary, I'm just saying to the museum that it should be archived, the rest of the story of this whakaputanga flag and its story right through. Okay, so there's a lot of it missing, and I'm putting this history from these old tūpunas back into where it should be in this bag here that I have to bring up to Waitangi and to show everything in front of everybody so they can witness. We do have the original titles, and we must sort it out with the Navy and make settlements this way. It's no use with the Treaty of Waitangi. It's a fraud, no end date contract agreement. They knew that. The principles of the treaty comes under this fraud acts of Parliament from 2009, 2010, when they opened the Parliament, opened the Supreme Court, and put all those acts and the 86 Act Constitution. Geoffrey Palmer, Sir Geoffrey Palmer, he got a problem. Now he's got a problem. He's got to, he's saying, New Zealand needs a new constitution. They need more than that. They need a whole new government, which is here in this book. It's a new government here. Charter. Old one, new one. Okay, it's all there. Everything's ready to go. Just need to get the British in here to take over. But I want to limit the way things are and leave the government to run themselves and their people out of debt if they can get out of it, because we're running credit. This is a pound note, levy debtor, credit, government running at the same time, parallel, and see how long they're gonna last there. So, back to the marae hire. So I'm going to let you know in a shorter video of the costing again, so that makes it brief because it's a long video. And I tend to make long ones instead of short ones. Someone said to me, don't make any short videos, just tell us everything. So I'm really telling you how things are going to run if it's well organised. And I'm one for organising hui on a marae so that it is successful in the end. We've done all the arrangements. Finally, the letter of reply from the Navy. I hope to get it today or Monday at the latest, of their intentions of helping us to put the flag up. Otherwise, we're going to, once we confiscate the land, we've already done that on Te Tihi Marae on the 4th of February 2016. But they didn't realise there, I was just saying to Wairiti, the organiser of the marae hire, booking, I was saying to her that I wrote to the Navy to leave the flag down so they could put our flag up, but no one was listening. No one was listening in the Marae. They were only worried about the TPPA and the flag. They weren't worrying about this flag. They completely forgot what I was saying on the 4th in front of the TPPA meeting, and on the 3rd, that was, we were on Te Marae, 3rd of February. And on the 4th, I got up again and said, we're going to confiscate the lands and we're going to confiscate the flagship of Admiralty, King William's flagship. We're going to confiscate the flags on it. We're going to confiscate the Marae, the land, and Te Marae, both Marae's, and the 1840 Treaty of Waitangi obelisk title. We're going to confiscate the whole lot. Okay, so we've gone through that. I've ministered it at the hui for the taumata. So between me and Kingi, we have that already documented. That's our business. That's our private business. Whatever we do on that marae is our private commercial contract, admiralty, court-martial law business. Nobody's business. These books are nobody's business. But I let the old taumatas, elders, take photos of them. Okay? Just so they know they've got something real looking at it. So I'm prepared to open up the books for people to see and explain it at the Wananga on the 13th and the 14th, and then the 15th finish it all off. So, Pōwhiri, 10 o'clock on Wednesday, expecting the Navy to be at the Pōwhiri, welcome, on the Marae, in a full-on taumata, elders and chiefs, hui, okay? A response from the government, or any one other than the Prime Minister, he's not allowed on there. He's not even allowed on Ngāti Whātua on Marae because of his stance against the Hapū signing the TPPA contract for his own private business and those countries that he signed with weren't thinking about King William and Britain. Okay, so Britain, you are responsible for the upkeep of our contract and the recovery of our lands and all the business of the King's Bench Court. And me, the Sheriff, look after me till I get to England and raise this flag after we raise it on your ship here of Admiralty, British ship, and I'll come over there and raise it on King William's William Yard Memorial next to it, and then into Westminster if we need to go there. But we're going to open this Commonwealth Government of the World, New World Order, on William Yard in Devon, Plymouth, England. Okay? So that's that. That wraps that up. And I'm back on this Marae, Hoia. To you, Kingi, it's good that you consented to Te Marae to raise your flag. It was up to you that I rely on to carry out the rest of the duties of the taumata of Te Marae, Ngāti Rehea Marae, and Ngāti Rahiri Marae, and Ngāti Kawa Marae. The Marae on the other side, that's up to you. You tell me what you want to do with the land, I'll do it for you as the land commissioner and sheriff to confiscate any such lands under the native acts of our law, King William's acts of Parliament 1830-1837 shall apply. Okay? That's as simple as it gets. Now the spirit side of things I leave to the other taumatas. Hohepa Epiha is looking after the Ngāpui Nui Tonu and the Taumata Komātua elders 39 hapu. I believe that's what it is, the last meeting. He's happy with progress to re-establish and reoccupy this flag in its rightful place at the top of the flagpole on the treaty grounds forever. It's not coming down, Kenny. It's not coming down. It is going to run the world from there. Okay, it's a Commonwealth of the World flag. I've set up the Commonwealth of the World government in the books. Okay, I've set it up. So we're talking about at Otau Marae, as being Cornwall Park, is the more likely place to have that parliament set up in that paddock. Going through that with Moihi Manukau when he was alive, while we were going up the hill, and to claim all that land back. That's the next one, after Cook Street, same time. The same time as the Waitangi land blocks. We have no reason why not to carry it out because of the consequences of John Key government threatening us, threatening our flag authority with his non-statement of confidence government. He opened, he more or less made or forced King Prince William to open the Supreme Court without his knowledge or the Queen's knowledge, that he never had the seal of the court from the Queen. The seal of the court, the seal of the New Zealand police, the seal of the New Zealand Supreme Court, and the seal of Parliament of New Zealand has not got a statement of confidence. Navy, you hear what I said? They have no consent in writing from the Queen to give them consent to use her name on their documents and to open the Supreme Court without the British Westminster's monarchy consent. No monarch, no Queen of England, no King of England, no ruling authority, no jurisdiction. That's why the judges never give their name. You've got a problem and a constitutional problem as well, because Sir Geoffrey Palmer said New Zealand need a new constitution. He's the one that put that 1986 constitution together with its principles of the Treaty of Waitangi 1840, when that was null and void as well, because it's got no end date contract with the Queen and the Maori iwi authorities. Is illegal. Now I'm saying to you, please, to stand aside while I seize my land back on 77 Cook Street. It was 66 Cook Street before, then it went to 61 Cook Street, then it went to 77 Cook Street, to 98 Wellesley Street. You see, you can't keep changing things around the same time as 2009 when Ann Tolley was the Minister of Police, and then it changed to Annette King. You see, and they changed again. They keep changing. At that year period of time, the skullduggery was going on with this Panama paper tax fraud havens here in New Zealand. They're caught in the middle of that, Navy and Police. I'm holding you liable, each person liable, and including CIB Detective Natalie Flowerdew Brown, Navy. They spirited her off to the Solomon Islands till the end of the year to keep her away from me and my barrister from pulling her into court. And her name's all over the Facebook and the YouTube. When I went to court, they arrested me illegally without a warrant, without authority, without a seal, without sovereignty, without any law. They broke every law in their book, even without the seal of the court. Okay, I'm talking authority here of a king, because I'm speaking as the surrogate King William IV, authority straight to Britain, over these lands. Okay, so that's what I've got the information here that no one can refute. That's why you stay silent. If you stay silent, John Martin, there's a message for you, Chief of Navy New Zealand and Rear Admiral. You stayed silent with me. You never answered my letters. You never. And that had the King's authority on it and the Chief's authority. You still ignore it, the same as the police ignore it. As a consequence, you lose everything. By closing your mouth, the law prevails. This is the law now, because you didn't answer me, the landowner, the landlord of these native lands that you're occupying only under lease titles. We're going to terminate at short notice. That's why we're seizing the Waitangi Treaty Grounds legally and lawfully and legitimately with these titles that you cannot prove. The iwi trust is not the landowners. They are only a legal fiction owner. They are not a native owner with the whakapapa and the British title. Okay? They have inferior titles, that's what I'm saying. Instruments of fraud, fiat money. Right? That's why I'm saying. The police must assist us in what I want to do with the chiefs. The Navy must assist us in what we want to do, not the businesses. The businesses are going to get the bill, Navy. The Navy is going to get the bill, personally, because the Pope said personally, because he took all your laws away with Admiralty, but not ours, because we have the overlying contract with the British Navy. Okay? They took away all the other ones in the world and demolished them. You cannot use those laws on us. They did use them on me. That's the other offence. The police used those UCC laws and civil laws and courier law and canon law and Admiralty law on me. The worst thing they did was took my shirt off with King William on it and his 8-point star, confiscated it. That's the biggest offence against the British Emperor, King William IV, and me speaking for the King. No one's going to take my place speaking for the King unless he's got all the titles. Okay? That's all I'm saying, plain as day. Now, I'm going back to this hiring the Marae game. So we got the cost. We got the cost of $2,874.75. So that's $500 out of that is for the bond, but get back. So if someone can help me out with all these costs, then I appreciate it, because I'm running everything myself. The whole, complete, everything. And so that's a job on its own. And also running the Marae when we are going through the time period. Right through. I'm keeping check on it. I've got my nephew, Desmond Wanoa. He's my right-hand man. And he'll be taking care of the security of the Marae with a group of people he can find. I'm sure there'll be no shortage of that. So he'll look after the gate and the people coming in, because they have to pay if they want to park themselves in the paddock. And there's certain places where the ground is soft that they don't want anybody to go on and drive. Okay, so there's a few rules, house rules, that I have to keep myself. Otherwise, I'm liable for anything that's misplaced, broken, or missing. Then I'm responsible for the extra costs. So bear with me while I go through this and finish off. We've got all the facilities in the caravan park, the camping ground, if we need it. I'm saying that if we got up to 60 people, then we'll stay in the Marae and keep it limited to that side and parking on the road. But if we have too many people, then we have to add more to the costs. It will be an extra cost to what I've just told you. I've been told that the numbers, we don't know the numbers, because I only got the permission from the Marae just today and from the other Marae and the Navy yesterday. So although I waited for a long time, it chewed away at my time I've got left till next Wednesday to have everything in place, and the Marae paid for it. So I don't, although Koha comes on the day of the porphyry, then it's very hard for me to determine how much is going to be collected at that event, which may run short as well. So I'm not too certain. I'll have to get a bit of hand from the old people and those who are coming. Please let me know how many people are coming, because I don't want surprises on that Marae. And I always know how many people are coming to Ahui at any other Marae I know I go to, but not this one, because it's been a big event. And like she said, it looks like it's going to swell in numbers. And that's a relief and a worry on top of it. What cost it's going to be extra to cover the cost of that. So our porphyry welcome is at 10 o'clock on the Wednesday, the 13th of April, to date, to just now. And the farewell, or porapuraki, is on the 15th, Friday, at 11 o'clock. And 12 o'clock we've shut the gates and gone off the site by 12 noon. We're having porphyry, and then 12 o'clock lunch, and then dinner at 6 o'clock roundabout after the hui. The hui starts after lunch at 1 o'clock. Till at least 4:30, and then dinner after that, as soon as we can. We're going to be cooking our own dinner, and so I need people to bring some kai with them, because this is an all-in-one event. It's for everybody. It's a national hui for anyone that is supporting this flag, no matter what it is, because we're talking about the whakamininga. It still means everyone in all the hapus around the country, because it's the one that the Navy recognises here, and the Navy in Britain recognises as being global. Okay, and international flag, this one, is the one that carries more weight on the trade and the banking and the pound note. Okay, so I just want to let you know, we're using that pound note to debtor all these people who have been caught and hiding here in this country. If you're hiding here, your wealth from the Ponzi scheme and from the Panama paper tax evasion, tax havens, and hiding your money here, you're going to get caught by our sheriffs. There won't be any shortage of sheriffs. It doesn't take much to teach a sheriff how to go and check his land and find who's on it. That's not going to be a big problem, because we're going to employ the British military here straight away. You're listening, British military? I'm ordering you here, straight onto my land blocks, at the East Cape, Rangitukia, on the Waipu River mouth. Straight there. Okay, bring the big machines, bring the whole lot, and get it ready, flattened out, and put these big planes in there. And the big ships come in over there to look after our seabeds and stop the nonsense with all the spraying the skies and poisoning the waters and killing the fish and all that. The elite is spoiling this earth. Okay, so come straight in. As soon as the flag goes up, I'll be in England to put the flag up there and clean up the rest of the mess there. Okay, so we're in a mode of confiscating any fraudulent wheeling and dealing in this country. Okay, starting here with John Key. John Key, the police are after you with this case file. Your number is on this case file number. The police were charged you on the 22nd of December 2009. You were charged with opening that parliament, the Supreme Court, without an oath of office. And you put the police at risk. You put the police at risk, you put the parliament at risk, and you put the courts at risk by your actions. As a consequence, you'll lose everything. And all the people who followed you is going to lose everything, no matter what. That's the Marae, King William IV Admiralty Court Martial Law working for this flag and us. I'm appealing to all the people in this country to follow the king. Follow the king and the pound note. It's clean, it's debt-free. It's the creditor. That's my job. Sheriff, creditor, King John. Okay? Now, King John is a commercial king, not a blood king like England. Okay? So I'm only there until King Ernest Augustus the V take that role to continuity of monarch to King William the IV, to William the Conqueror, to King Solomon, straight through. Okay? That inheritance and our contract with that lot. All the gold missing on the Queen's side. As soon as the Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth came in and mucked the whole monarchy. They don't want any more monarchy, but that's her. We still prevail. No one can stop the king and our ruling authority under this flag. It's fixed to us and nothing's going to change that. Only us. Okay, thank you very much, people. I hope I've said myself clear. And I'll make a short video after this to explain the Marae protocol for this hui. Otherwise, there's every chance that we may not have a hui if we can't raise the money to pay for the hire of the Marae. And they demand that it's a full-on porphyry for something as important as this. Had to go on that Marae. Okay, so we'll leave it there for the moment. John Wanar, Auckland, New Zealand. Bid you a nice day. Bye.